You and I take this for granted that we feel the world around us. We feel the wind in our face and hair, motor function, walking, running, grabbing, doing things, speaking. Just imagine this is taken away from you from the neck down, or sometimes worse.
Paralysis used to mean forever, but what if this brain implant could reverse it?
As long as you can interface with the brain, you can enable a patient that has lost function to regain pretty much everything that he or she has had.
It's one of several massive leaps in brain science technology.
A monkey playing Pong using only its mind.
He is feeling me touching this robotic arm.
Long considered the realm of science fiction, brain-computer interface technology is now a reality. And for people who have lost function, it's changing their lives.
After my injury, I tried everything I could to not let the injury define my life. I look back on 12 years ago when I had my spinal cord injury, and there's so much more hope now.
We're not going to screw this up, and we'll help as many people as we can.
This is Just Might Work, a show about surprising solutions to our biggest problems.
How does it feel to be sort of at this moment now?
I can't believe it's happening.
As we find more ways to integrate our bodies with technology, there's one application that has kind of represented the final frontier, our brain.
The brain is really the part of our body that controls everything that is going on, what you do, what you want to do, what you don't want to do, perceiving the world around you. All of that happens in the brain.
For some people with paralysis, ALS, neurodegenerative disorders, or other disabilities, the connection between the brain and the body is broken. And that's where brain-computer interface, or BCI, technology comes in, to reestablish the connection between thoughts and motor functions so that people can move or feel again.
Middle. Pinky.
There we go.
All of this started almost 30 years ago. As a teenager, I was working with disabled children at that time and realized that it was extremely frustrating that we were not really offering any great solutions.
I met Florian at high school, and it was the kind of high school where people asked each other what they wanted to do later in life. Frankly, I didn't have a clue. But when I asked Florian, he said he wanted to create the link between artificial and bionic limb.
Florian and Marcus eventually came together to start Blackrock Neurotech. It has become the world's leading brain-computer interface company, producing the majority of BCI implants that are or have been in patients ever. The mechanism that underpins the work is pretty wild. A chip like this is implanted into the motor cortex. As a user thinks of an action like moving their hand, a computer decodes and analyzes those brain signals through an algorithm. Then that digital command is transmitted to external devices, or in some cases, stimulates muscles or nerves to allow patients to move their own arms and hands. It can even translate thoughts to type a message or use a cursor. And if that's not enough, it can also translate sensations back from a prosthetic so the user can actually feel again.
Essentially giving some of those capabilities back, the excitement, the fire, the hope that this is instilling is very inspiring.
This is exactly what happened with Ian Burkhardt. You may remember Ian from our series Superhuman. After a tragic diving accident, Ian was left unable to move most of his body. But one of Blackrock's brain implants connected to electrodes on his arm restored his ability to move his hand.
Understanding and coming to terms with the fact that I have a disability has been a process. I needed help with everything from getting dressed, getting up in the morning, going to the bathroom. But the NeuroBridge BCI trial acted as extra intensive occupational therapy for me. I know that it can really benefit other individuals' lives, and I'm really excited to see it get into the hands of more and more people.
But the problem? This tech is typically limited to small-scale trials, and patients like Ian could only utilize it in the lab, not at home, where it was needed most.
All right. See you next week. Have a good weekend.
Have a good weekend.
We've come a long way, but up until today, you could only get access as part of a multi-million dollar clinical research study. That is changing.
And before that happens, Blackrock is turning to patients like Ian to truly understand how this tech could be life-changing for people with disabilities outside the lab.
I'm working on some of the engineering design of the software and the hardware, as well as creating a coalition for other individuals like myself to really make sure that they're gonna be something that will actually be used by the disability community.
Whatever we can do to give someone like Ian and other BCI pioneers a platform, because at the end of the day, when you get that feedback from a patient, that's very different from asking clinicians, researchers, or the general public what that patient population might need. We're already today talking about a patient population of 600 million patients that suffer from neurological disorders. I think this kind of technology, a neural interface with various different applications, can and will provide a life-changing impact to millions of patients.
The disabled community is the launching point, but next-generation applications could expand to blindness, depression, and beyond.
Really what we're trying to do is open it up to others to build additional tools, interfaces to enable people to do their jobs, novel classes of computer games and entertainment. Eventually, this may be something for first responders, military or others that may be able-bodied but need faster reflexes or support to be safer in certain environments. It's endless, the possibilities.
I've seen the promise that it holds. I've been able to think about moving my hand again, and it actually moves. I thought I would never do that again. And that hope and possibility really ignites a fire within myself to stay motivated to making these types of products something that everyone has access to.